Good evening, friends. This is time for some sort of quote-unquote knowledge video. And something that I noticed, see, we should all not be under the impression that our markets are moving for any intrinsic strengths that we may have. They are moving because of global market. That point is clear. Now, I am going to today compare S&P 500 with Nifty and Bank Nifty. And I would like to compare where these indices are relative to their moving averages. Moving average, as we know, is the point of equilibrium of indices, stocks, commodities, all traded instruments. So first of all, let's see where is the 20 DMA of the S&P 500. It is here somewhere. I think let me do an exact figure. Okay. So S&P 500 20 DMA is 3634, and we are right now at 3650, which is about 0.5% away from its 20 day moving average. Another parameter we want to see is how strong the market is, and that I generally like to look at the RSI. An RSI above 65-70 shows that the particular market is strong, which means it will keep finding support at lower levels. Now this RSI is trading below levels of 60. As you can see here, it has recently broken down from 60. So S&P 500 is losing strength. Now relative to this, let's see where the Nifty and the Bank Nifty are doing, how well in terms of the 20 day moving average or the RSI. Let me remove all these lines so that we can see clearly. Now here the Nifty 20 DMA is at 13,080, and we have closed at 13,513. So this is almost, if I am not wrong, about 4% away from current level. In terms of RSI, the Nifty RSI is at 76. So again, while in the short run we could be strong, but if we do everything the way the S&P 500 does, then chances are that we do catch-ups also on the downside. So the risk of that remains on the table. So as far as I am concerned, if you have long positions, now your stop should be 13,400. Any sort of closing below 13,400 means that you should be out. Okay. Similarly, let's check out the Bank Nifty. The Bank Nifty 20-day moving average is at 29,645. Again, way lower than current prices, almost 1,000 points lower. And Bank Nifty, if you see, the RSI, while not weak, is not as strong as the Nifty. But again, it is 70, which is respectable. So, if again, we have to follow the S&P 500, then we should be losing momentum and coming off. So for the moment, you will see that whenever there are declines, you know, the market is coming back. But my sense is that we will soon need to catch up with the S&P 500, and on the downside, so Bank Nifty, your support is about 30,000, you know, 250-300. So below that, it would start to really weaken. But S&P 500 seems to be leading, you know, a correction or a consolidation in the market. And this is something you should take note of, because our bravado generally lasts a few days, and then post that, we tend to fall in line with the global market. This was a little video, 3 minute, 4 minute video, but something to keep an eye on, because as many people are there, you know, you have so many other views, but this is one view you should be taking, because momentum often leads price. So if momentum in the leader market is failing, then chances are it could happen even here, but this can take a few days. All of this, you know, taking the market up in the morning and then suddenly collapsing it down, etc. This, I would think, smells a bit of distribution. So as I told you yesterday, the range is 13,450, 13,600. But on the downside, I think now, given the narrowness of the market, sooner or later we will come on one side, and the indication may be given by the S&P 500. That should be it. Hope you have a good weekend, and you'll probably come with more knowledge videos over the weekend. Take care and good night.